Evening folks, this is BestInSlot with a very quick little update for Jurassic World Evolution. Now we're going to get a lot more information on these pteranodons tomorrow. That is of course the date of the new live stream. It was meant to be today. I mentioned in my last video that it was meant to be today, but it got pushed back to tomorrow. So Thursday there's going to be a new developer live stream for the new DLC, where we're going to see Mission 6 and therefore the aviaries and the pteranodons in a lot more detail. But until then, the Jurassic World Evolution Twitter, just about an hour or so ago, has posted a new message saying the following: "Pteranodons are coming with Jurassic World Evolution, return to Jurassic Park! Exclamation point. With wingspans over 7 meters, these reptiles would have been extremely light and delicate in order to fly." So, we're going to take a quick little look at this video. I do apologize, they don't really upload high quality to their, Twitter, so when it's blown up to full screen and stuff, it's a little bit lower in quality. Feel free to check it out in small size on their Twitter though. Here we go. And that of course means there's no sound as well, because, Twitter. Unfortunately, there's not much we can do about that. So, we're going to take a quick little look at this and just point out some stuff as we go along. Like I said, this really shouldn't be a very long video in the slightest, but it's news, it's new video content. This is really our best ever look at the pteranodons so far, so it's definitely worth taking a little look at. Now, it's worth remembering these are... I'm going to play this in the background. This is a looped animation. The pteranodons go through the same animation. So if you stood here at this position watching this pteranodon do this, he's calling back, probably not the right noise, and then he flies away. If you stood and watched that exact position, this little, pillar right here, he would come back in about a minute to 2 minutes. I don't know exactly how long the loop is, but it is definitely a loop. But I will say the loop is long enough that it doesn't really matter. At the end of the day, although they are looped, which is kind of what we expected, it lasts for so long that it's very hard to realize that it's a loop unless you are expressly looking for it to be a loop. And you can see another pteranodon in the background there. Is that actually a different skin? Can we take a little look at that? It looks like that could be a different skin. It's really hard to tell in this. What we do have a good look at is the default skin in more detail than ever. You can see that right there. You can really see the teeth as well. I know people are upset about the teeth, but it is a Jurassic Park 3 pteranodon. It would have had teeth. It's meant to be based on the film, not necessarily science. I know it makes no sense whatsoever in the real world, but it's a Jurassic Park 3 pteranodon, and it is, again, perfect with those tints of red, sort of the darker patches coming in at the top and the bottom of the beak, the striping sort of down towards the back of the crest. It looks terrifying. It looks like it's straight out of Jurassic Park 3. I am most excited to see this at nighttime, or at least maybe like a dusk sort of time, and hoping we can recreate some of the atmosphere from the aviary scene in Jurassic Park 3, which is, in my opinion, the best scene in the film. So, what we're doing here is getting our best look at one of the loops, one of the animation loops the pteranodons are going to be in. Basically, as you put in your 6 pteranodons, which is the most the aviary can hold, as far as I can tell, each pteranodon will basically pick one of those 6 loops until they're all taken up, and they'll just follow that loop over and over again. So this, we're seeing one of those animation loops. He flies down, soars down, swings around, lands on a pillar, sort of shuffles, and then does a little call. This will be making a calling noise, I believe. Some people have commented it looks a little bit like an eating animation. That's how a pteranodon would eat. It would rear its head back and kind of gook, 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 the fish down like that. Based on what I saw, I didn't see any feeding animations in the aviary. I don't know if that's a thing. I know you don't place down feeders, or I don't believe you send people to feed them either. That's not to say feeding isn't part of it. I didn't see every animation loop for the entire thing, and you can't follow the individual pteranodons. What you do in the aviary is instead select one of 9 camera positions and you watch. I don't think this is an actual camera position. Well, I think what this might be is you sit here, like this will be a camera right here. And what they'll do is zoom in just there, because you can zoom in and control these cameras individually. It's pretty cool. And then the pteranodon is this thing. It's a really good look at the pteranodons. More than anything else to take away from this, I'm not bringing any particularly new information. I accept that this is a light piece of news, to say the least. But it's a really good look at the pteranodon. By far the best you folks at home have had so far. So hopefully you can appreciate that. I think it looks really good. Like I said, the looped animations aren't a problem. The design is great. There is a blue skin. A lot of people are hoping for the Lost World pteranodon. There is a blue skin. The rainforest one, but it's a darker blue and has this kind of yellow patching around the eyes. I would not particularly say, sorry, excuse my voice there, I would not particularly say it looks like the Lost World Pteranodon. It makes a lot of sense they've gone for the Jurassic Park 3 variant over the Lost World variant, because the Jurassic Park 3 variant was a much bigger part of the film than the Lost World variant was. I'm going to play through it one more time. Swing, bada bada, swings down, camera view shifts around. And there we go. This would all be possible in your aviary, these exact camera views. Maybe not this kind of slow, you can see the camera's actually panning slightly to the right there, that wouldn't be possible. But you could, you know, sit on a camera and track a Pteranodon as it flies around. You don't have full control. From what I could see, you couldn't track individual Pteranodons, but the cameras are pretty good. And that's about it really, folks. Great look at the Pteranodon. We'll be back with more tomorrow. You know, we're going to have the stream that they're doing. They're doing a full stream of Mission 6. What we'll probably do is watch that here on the channel and just commentate over it and stop it and sort of talk about things as they happen and as they are unveiled. Though I have played Mission 6 and told you all I learnt about Mission 6, I'm sure we can get some new information tomorrow anyway. So, something to look forward to. Until then, thank you very much for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Remember to check out this link at the Twitter down below. If you watch it in slightly smaller size, it looks higher quality, which is nice. Cheers, much love as always. Bye bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.